Amazon's Fire TV Cube has just made its way into the market, close to a year after the Apple TV 4K. But which one is superior? Or better put, which one is right for you? First off, I'd have to say that the Apple TV 4K is more aesthetically pleasing. It's got a fan on the bottom, while the Cube has a speaker for its built-in Alexa. It's got 8 microphones and 4 buttons on top, including mute. The Cube has an included Ethernet adapter, but it's limited to 100 megabits per second, compared to the Apple TV 4K's built-in gigabit Ethernet port with 1000 megabits per second speed. You can pick up the Cube for $120, or you can get it in a bundle with Amazon's Cloud Cam for an extra 80 bucks. It's incredibly easy to set up, and it automatically syncs to the Cube. Just ask it to show your Cloud Cam, and you'll get a live feed momentarily. The Apple TV 4K starts at 180 bucks, but it also comes with twice as much storage as the Cube, as well as an extra gigabyte of RAM. And you can pay just $20 more for another 32 gigs of storage on top. So what makes up the difference in price? Well, for starters, the Fire TV Cube is simply last year's Fire TV combined with an Echo Dot, which total a matching $120. However, Amazon is selling the combo for 95 bucks if you buy them together. The Fire TV has the exact same internals as the Cube, other than the storage. It can also do pretty much everything the Cube can do if you've got an Echo, except for turning your TV on and controlling stuff like your cable box. The Apple TV 4K's price tag is justified by its A10X Fusion processor, which is from the 2017 iPad Pro. A10X is so fast that it matches the performance of some of Apple's new MacBooks, especially when looking at graphics performance. The Cube, however, has a chipset that's made with architecture from 2012. It's got a slightly faster version of the CPU that comes in the Raspberry Pi 3, and the graphics chip is an ultra-low power GPU meant for entry-level phones and wearables. No wonder you can get the Cube for only $120. Both devices support 4K 60fps and HDR10, except the Apple TV 4K supports the superior Dolby Vision HDR as well. The Cube already supports Dolby Atmos surround sound, and the Apple TV 4K will catch up when tvOS 12 gets released this September. On the plus side, Apple will automatically upgrade supported iTunes movie purchases to Atmos versions for free. If you don't know what Atmos means, you can click the card above to see how it works. There's also a bunch of new features being added with tvOS 12, including third-party Siri remote support, password autofill, zero sign-on cable, and more. Now let's compare how they actually work. The Siri remote is made out of metal and glass over the plastic Alexa voice remote. It's also got a built-in battery that fast charges via lightning instead of a couple of batteries on the Alexa remote that many reviewers say drain too quickly. The Cube's remote also lacks volume controls, so you'll have to resort to using your TV remote or asking Alexa to turn up the volume. The issue with this is that the volume only goes up by a maximum of 10 at a time, and you can't ask Alexa to turn up to the max, so you'll have to ask her multiple times. Thankfully, the Siri remote has volume controls and a touchpad, making navigation a lot quicker than using the buttons on the Cube's remote. However, we do love that you can ask the Cube to turn on your TV and other connected devices like an Xbox or PlayStation, but even though Alexa is a lot smarter than Siri, searching for movies and shows is a pretty bad experience. We searched for new rentals and we got mostly Prime movies. We searched for action movies and got a bunch of shows. We asked for top-rated movies and we simply got movies. The Prime movie results were very limited compared to what Amazon offers, and if you search for a certain category of Prime movies, you get a bunch of non-Prime content. Luckily, searching for movies with a certain actor or made by a certain director works pretty well. You can also use your voice to scroll through the results, but it takes forever compared to using the remote. The worst part about Alexa is that you can't search for 4K or 4K HDR movies. Alexa will simply search for movies. So you have to use the remote to manually go to the 4K movie section to find them all. On the Apple TV 4K, every search result is completely accurate. From searching for 4K movies, to 4K HDR movies, to action shows, you get exactly what you want every single time. The best part is that every 4K HDR movie available for rent is available to rent in 4K HDR, whereas on the Cube, there's a lot of movies with available 4K HDR versions that you can only rent in regular HD quality. On top of that, there's more new 4K releases on Apple's iTunes that allow rentals compared to Amazon Prime. Interestingly, the Cube has this 4K movie only available as a $25 purchase, even though it's available for free on Netflix. Searching is also incredibly quick compared to the Cube. It happens instantly, and you can get more search results by scrolling right, whereas on the Cube, you're limited to a maximum of 100. The UI is a lot more smooth compared to the Cube, which will sometimes lag up and take some time to load certain apps or initiate search results. One plus for the Cube is that you can watch 4K content on YouTube, which won't work on Apple TV since it doesn't support YouTube's VP9 codec. Both devices work well for their own ecosystems, like movies, photos, and music, so whichever one you're more invested in may work better for you. The nice thing about the Apple TV is that you can AirPlay content straight from your Apple device, even when showing others photos or videos. Apple TV also has podcasts, which works very well and is convenient for home listening. When it comes to games, you get a better selection of games with higher quality graphics on the Apple TV, thanks to its powerful processor. You get mostly basic Android mobile games on the Cube, and when you're not using your devices, you get much better screensavers on the Apple TV as well. Overall, the Apple TV 4K is the superior streaming device, except for the fact that it lacks hands-free voice controls. But to be honest, the Alexa voice controls on the Cube are so bad that you'll have to resort to using your remote anyways. The Cube does gain some pluses for being able to turn the TV on and control other devices, but it's not that big of a deal for a lot of people. And if you're looking for the best 4K HDR experience, the Apple TV 4K has a lot more content to offer. Let us know what you thought about this comparison in the comment section below, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on more videos like this one. And we'll see you in the next one.
If you enjoyed this video, like it and hit that subscribe button. Also, check out our price guide, which makes it extremely easy to find the best deals on Apple products updated daily. Be sure to follow us on social media, and we'll see you in the next video.